if I can see her, live. Hello, everyone. Welcome to our first live stream concert. And we are hoping that you're staying safe and healthy with your families, with your friends, colleagues. And we almost, it's our first experience, so we are a little bit nervous. So we're just gonna wait a little bit for more folks gonna join us. So we'll start in 5 minutes, okay? Thank you.
How to turn this?
Like this, yeah. It's good.
Okay. 31 people. Shall we start?
Just give it 1 more minute. 32. Yeah, I think people will. It's okay.
Okay.
Can we give it to 8:05?
No.
Like we said. Okay. You need a tune?
Yeah, yeah. A tune. You can start. Hello, everyone, again, and welcome to our live stream concert, Hausmusik, which Margaret and I have been organized in a collaboration with the Boston-based nonprofit Ballets Russes Initiative. I am Liubomyr Senyshyn, and I'm thrilled that all of you are joining us tonight. And I would like to say greetings to all of our friends, families, colleagues, people all around the world who are watching, and it's a different time zone now. You know, someone is not sleeping, you know, as my mom, I hope so. And our students, teachers who are watching, as well as our supporters of Ballets Russes, including members of their BR 360 program. Thank you for your support by tuning in to hear us play, and thank you as well to all of those of you who have made a contribution on Eventbrite. If you haven't had the chance to donate yet and you would like to support us, you can do so. We have the link in the description of the live stream. And make sure that after the concert, and we hope you will join us and Anna Weinstein from Ballets Russes, that we're saying hi, that she's also watching right now, on Zoom for Q&A and some virtual socializing. And now I would like to encourage you to grab your favorite drink or a glass of wine, or even if you haven't had your dinner, you can, you know, eat and put the laptop or iPad, wherever you have, to enjoy the beauty of music together. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Just heard the Dvorak Sonatina in G major, and this actually small scale sonata was composed in 1893, and actually it was Dvorak's last chamber composition written in the United States while he was director of the National Conservatory of Music. And mostly he composed this piece when he was in New York City. So it's actually an interesting factor. That's why also we played this. This piece that Dvorak Sonatina, he dedicated to his children. So he was watching them how they're growing up from the little kids and up to the teenagers. So basically you can hear, you know, in the second movement, this lullaby, and the third movement, it's when the toys become real. All this moment, you know, the child moments, and when you're like, you know, when you're still in your parents' hands, it's actually, I think this is the perfect example of Dvorak, this bright melodic and rhythmic charm. The next piece that we would like to play for you, it's going to be actually a friend of Dvorak. It's going to be Tchaikovsky, and the melody you're about to hear, it's the third movement of Opus 42, entitled «Воспоминания о дорогом месте», which translates in English «Memory of Dear Place». So Tchaikovsky, you know, he spent a lot of time in the, you know, traveling, and also he had a really nice friend, Надежда Вамек, who actually was a really, really close to friend, and she was actually supporting him. So every time when he would come to visit her and stay in her house, he would tell that, it's so nice to be here without, surrounded by people and surrounded by nature, and finally I can enjoy my composing. Oh, sorry about that. Oh, well, why it's popping up my left. Sorry, guys. It's just the thing that it's popping. You know, it's our first time again. We will do more, so we will get professional. So yeah, so now we would like to play the Tchaikovsky melody for you, the closest friend of Borja. Hope you enjoy. Since Margaret loves French music, so I think she would love to tell you about our next French section in our program.
So we will continue with possibly one of Debussy's most famous works, Clair de Lune. Now this piece is usually heard on its own, as you'll hear now. However, it was originally intended as the third movement of four in a dance suite called Suite Bergamasque, which was actually a solo piano composition originally, and it was published in 1894. Okay, so Suite Bergamasque. A suite is a collection of many dances, and the title of Bergamasque leads us to actually the folk dances of Bergamo, Italy.
Which we've been last summer.
Yes, we play music in there in the summer, which is wonderful.
Sorry.
That's okay. So please enjoy Clair de Lune in its not original form, but in its most beloved form.
Thank you. Charles Massenet, I would actually like to share some fun, wonderful news. I share a birthday. So both of us have a birthday on the 12th of May, which has just passed. I just turned 25. However, he just turned 108. So we would like to congratulate him on this wonderful achievement by celebrating him with his Meditation from his opera Thais, premiered in 1894. This piece was originally created as an instrumental intermezzo between scenes in Act Two, in which Thais, who is a devotee of Venus, is confronted by Athenaeus, and he encourages her, urges her even to leave her life of luxury and pleasure in favor of one that follows the salvation of God. This piece follows her inner reflection and struggle as she goes through this, and eventually she makes the decision to follow Athenaeus into the desert and ultimately to a new life. Not only is this piece wonderfully crafted and loved by many, it's a great avenue for us to reflect upon the wanderings of our lives and where we want to be going forward with them, especially in this time. Please enjoy Meditation by Charles Massenet.
We have a benefit of an online concert that we can actually drink water.
Drink water. It's not a bad idea.
Yes, I love an online concert. Thank you. Before maybe tell us a little bit more about our next pieces, I would like to say that I'm grateful and I'm actually really lucky that I'm not only having it next to me, I'm also a composer. So especially during these times when you're stuck inside, you know, it's really nice and actually cool to have someone who can write and for you music and you can actually play together. So I would introduce you, my favorite composer, Margaret Boslow.
These three pieces for violin, they're extremely short. We're being shortly after Liubomyr and I actually met, and I really wanted to learn more about how to write for this instrument and also what kind of colors and sounds both the instrument and the person holding it can create. For most of my life, I've been fascinated by language, how people use it, and the kind of mystique it can create. It's something as simple as an everyday function, but it can be quite special. So each of these vignettes is entitled with and inspired by one or two words in languages that either my friends or my colleagues have spoken around me that sort of defy overly simple emotional understanding. Some of them don't even translate into our language. The first, Magua Frizen, is half Portuguese, half English. The first half, Magua, translates to a type of heartbreak that can only be recognized in someone's face. They can't describe it with their words. You can only see it in their expression. And the second half of that, Frizen, contrast this first word by meaning a shiver of pleasure. The second short piece is called Sehnsucht. It's German and translates as a feeling of yearning for a home that you used to know or you used to have. and the third and last piece is entitled Balter, which is actually, of course, an English word of Northern Germanic descent, I suppose. And it means to dance rather artlessly, but with great enjoyment. So please enjoy these three short pieces that I composed.
So we would like to thank you again for staying us tonight, and that's going to be piece again by wonderful composer Margaret Boswell, and she actually composed this piece in the city called Cremona, where actually it's our second residency, second summer residency. Unfortunately, we cannot go there this year, but we will bring some memories from Cremona. So please enjoy this small encore piece. Thank you again for watching, supporting, staying with us. And please don't forget to join us for Zoom Q&A and virtual socializing right after this. Okay, thank you again and hope to see all of you on Zoom. Bye.